Hi, it's Andy Tarnoff, the publisher of OnMilwaukee, and I am here in Phoenix, Arizona for Brewers Spring Training, and I'm here with Tyler Barnes, our friend from the Brewers for many years, and we are going to take a tour of American Family Fields of Phoenix, which used to be known as.
Well done.
Yeah, again, it's going to take me a while to get used to calling it not Maryvale Baseball Park, but today's the second day of the second game at home, and we checked it out yesterday, and now we're going to take you guys around, and maybe you can give us a little bit of background about how different this is after 20 years and what new things we can see.
Sure. So, you know, we really look at this as a brand new complex. I know in some ways it was a renovation, but largely the place was rebuilt from the ground up. So we do have the seating bowl is primarily the same. We did rip out all the old benches that were down the line, so several thousand seats were put in, permanent seats. Biggest change that people would see when they're looking at the field is the new video board, which replaces a scoreboard that was worse than
that old scoreboard was not a great scoreboard, but this one is as good as anyone in the Cactus League, I would say.
Yeah, we didn't want to overwhelm the place with a scoreboard that was Miller Park size.
Right.
That's appropriate for 40,000 to 45,000 people, but something for an 8,000 to 10,000 seat stadium, we felt like we came up with the right number. So then, as you work your way down the right field line, every concession stand, every restroom, those are all completely newly built. We demolished all the old ones down there. We widened the concourse by another 10 to 30 feet, depending on where you are. So that used to be a problem where you get
it got kind of skinny, right?
Yeah, because everybody used to enter down the line.
Right, so that's a new thing, is there are two new entrances, right?
Yeah.
So there's one over here behind the plate.
The primary entrance now, and if yesterday is any indication, I think about 75% of the people will now enter from behind home plate, which is typical of most ballparks. And then from there, you'll fan out to your seat to the right field side, left field side. We do still have an entrance in right field. We do have some parking that's up along that side.
Okay.
So people can enter from there, and you actually go through a couple of practice fields on your way on that side. So it's sort of a neat place to go.
The other thing I noticed is you get right into the fan zone.
Yeah.
We just take a
walk over there. Sure. The team store is about 3 times bigger than what we had in the past. Okay. Not only allows for more people in there, but we don't need more. We've created a lot of room for more product. So it's not just what you see out front, but we're able to store a lot more product in the back.
Okay.
So you're going to have a lot more selection. We'll take a quick look inside here. But the old team store does still exist. It's an auxiliary team store now. So we have ease of access and tons of products.
Okay, you're going to have to get closer from the bottom. Mm-hmm. The thing I noticed is the prices are lower.
Prices are a little bit lower, yeah. We took over the retail operations this year, and so the Brewers are running it, so we have been able to, in some ways, bring down prices.
Some of these t-shirts were $50 last year, or 2 years ago, and now they're $28.
Yeah. Yeah, we did work hard to look for some economies where we could bring the prices down and create some great value for people.
Yeah, and I also think just the quality, I've been here 19 times, so I've seen good t-shirts and bad t-shirts, but I think the stuff this year looks really cool. So
yeah.
I don't know if you guys brought in new designers or how that works.
Yeah, but all the way up to our ownership, the retail is a huge priority, and like I said, with the ability now to have a really expansive storage area and a huge floor out here, we can just order a lot more product, a lot more variety. So yeah, people that are coming in here, if yesterday's any indication, the retail business is going to be very robust.
People can come in here separate of going into the ballpark too, right?
Correct. So. Yeah. So the door that we just came in is open when the team is on the road. I think we opened it February 12th this year,
okay.
So before the team starts even working out, we had it open. So
cool.
It won't be open year round, but it will be open during the entire spring season.
Okay. What else should we look at?
So let's go ahead. We'll go back into the offices and the player areas. As you work your way along here,
All of this is newly built. So what we're walking on right now was parking.
Yep.
Over here you had a minor league building. So now you have everything under one roof. So all of this is new. We have the retired numbers that are along here. You can read about all of our, the iconic people associated with the Brewers.
And I like, just aesthetically speaking, I like how the visual, the color schemes have all kind of become kind of desert brown.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit more unifying than yeah. It's a lot of blue and gray.
Yeah,
and
we did work to bring everything into the same colors. You know, we used to have the sort of the blue that you saw in the press box in the old building. And the problem with blue is in July, whatever you put blue on or red on, it's going to fade to look very washed out in a very short period of time. Whereas these colors that were selected by the architects, they really don't fade.
So did I read this was this a $90 million project?
No, it's $50 million. It's over $60
million. Okay, that's a significant amount of money, though.
As I joke, every day that I'm here, I spend another X amount of dollars with people saying, "Hey, what about this? What about this? Can we add this or that?" So it's still an ongoing project.
Yeah, so there will be continuing changes as the years move ahead.
And we already had a list of things that we were going to do for next year. In terms of renovating some of the minor league fields and grounds crew area.
Right.
So we have a number of things that we're that we're looking to improve upon or add to the project for next year.
So there was some concern a couple of years ago that the Brewers may not stay in Maryvale, but now we're locked in here for a while, right?
Yeah. We did explore a number of different alternatives. I think, you know, the goal being here, we're familiar with Maryvale. We have deep roots in Maryvale. And, you know, the location, in terms of it being central, you can't beat it. So, you know, getting to other facilities for games, where, you know, also being where players live, things like that, it's very close. It's really the only complex that is still in Central Phoenix, and that's a huge
plus. And it's also, I think fans maybe don't realize how gigantic it is, because if you go to Scottsdale Stadium, it's pretty cool, but it's little.
Now, we're very lucky. You know, it was a little bit of a challenge. It's on 60 acres.
Right.
And so we didn't expand the footprint of the facility. We had 60 acres to work with, and you still have to have parking.
Right.
That you have to have your playing fields. So one of the big challenges was the space that we had available to us. How do we best use that?
Yeah.
So, you know, the amount of space under a roof is more than double. So and the idea was, okay, let's bring all the players under one roof. So you have the minor league side over here, so all the minor league players are over there. The major league players over here,
okay,
they all meet here in the middle in the weight room, which is one of the larger weight rooms.
And you've seen other weight rooms. I mean, is this a pretty high quality facility?
It is. It's a very good size. Again, it went when you get all the players in here early in the morning, it's pretty full up. As you can see here, we built a there's a loft space up here,
okay.
And one of the things we're probably going to do next year is we designed this and engineered it so that it could hold cardio equipment. So
okay.
And the cardio equipment up there, be able to add more square footage.
Okay.
Then we'll go out to our agility field.
And fans can walk and see some of this stuff. I mean, that's the access here is pretty unprecedented.
Yeah. Most fans will enter through that archway that you can see right over there. About 75% of fans will come up through that way.
Okay.
And they'll walk along this path right behind that fence there. And you'll have guys warming up here before the game. So, yeah, the proximity to players, whether you are coming in from over here or you're coming in from that, as I said, the east side, where you're coming through two of the practice fields, the proximity to the players probably is closer than it even was last year.
I think that's an intimacy thing that people who haven't been to spring training don't realize, just how many Brewers and how many minor league players are going to see running around and have a chance to say hi to them, watch them practice. It's just one of those things that's just really unique, I think, to spring training. Brewers fans should take this as an opportunity to really increase their fans.
Yeah, it's a fantastic, I mean, look, we're looking at 75 degrees today. It's beautiful, and you do have the opportunity to be close to not just the major league team, but like you're talking about the minor league team. We've got close to 200 minor league players in the system, and they're all here as well. So I think a lot of people don't realize this is a 12-month per year facility. We have two minor league teams that play here, and then we run all of our rehabilitation for injured players out of here. We have extended spring training. We have fall league, instructional league. So we actually have a full-time staff down here that on the business operations and grounds crew side is about 25 people, and then that doesn't even include all the player development staff.
And then Fantasy Camp is here also.
Fantasy Camp, yeah. So this place, it goes 12 months out of the year.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
It's awesome.
Okay. Anything else we should see?
No,
over here?
I think you can see over here. We've got some indoor batting tunnels. These are the first ones that were built from the ground up in Arizona.
Okay.
A lot of technology in the indoor side. Again, when it's 110 degrees here, we want guys to be able to be in some comfort. But we also can put a lot of technology behind there that would not survive well on the outside. And then behind that, we have six more batting cages. In Miller Park, an exact replica of Miller Park's field, back there, built to the exact dimensions.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Done with laser measurements and everything back there.
So they can really just get a sense of what it feels like to play in Milwaukee.
Yeah. So this is really, we think it's taken the complex. The old complex building was built in 1997, was state of the art.
Yeah.
Over time, it had become one of the more challenging ones.
Yeah.
And now it's right back up to being right at the very top.
And then just from a business perspective, we're coming off the second best season in the history of the franchise.
Yeah.
There's got to be a lot of excitement just for the team and for the fans. This could be a good month, right?
Yeah, this is going to be a great month. Our sales are... ticket sales are up well into the double digits.
Great.
So we are doing phenomenally well. Like I said yesterday, we did really strong numbers in both retail and concessions. The thing I really like about this from the fan perspective is the new concession stands, we can now cook in them. In the past, we had to cook in a commissary, bring the food over to all the concession stands.
Sure.
Now we can actually cook in the concession stands. So the food you're going to get, we can do more variety. It's going to be hotter. It's going to be fresher. We just think the overall experience is going to be really good.
All right. Well, that's what I need to hear. I think we should go watch some baseball. Thank you very much, Tyler.
You bet, Andy.
It's great to see you. See you on opening day.
Great. We'll see everybody.
All right. Here we are at American Family Fields of Phoenix, which is going to take me a while to get used to saying that because I call this Maryvale Baseball Park, which is where I've been coming for spring training since 1998. And I got my photographer, Aaron Labor, from Front Row Photography here. And we are here about a half an hour before they open up the gates. So we're going to give you a kind of quiet behind-the-scenes tour of this new ballpark, which if you've been to Maryvale before, on some levels it looks different, and on some levels it looks the same. First thing I think you're going to notice is this view of the ballpark. The seating bowl actually looks almost identical, other than some font changes, and they took out some bleachers and replaced them with seats. So it has a better, bigger capacity now. But what I noticed most is just a big color change. So everything was kind of blue and white, and now it's all this sort of shade of desert brown. It looks a little bit nicer. I've been trying to decide whether or not this $60 million renovation was designed for the fans, or designed, is your finger in front of the lens? Designed for the fans or designed for the players, and I think it was more designed for the players because we got a behind the scene tour of the weight room, some of the facilities, and those are top notch. I think for the fans, it still kind of looks like Maryvale, which is not a bad thing, but it is certainly not on the level of, it's not on the level of fanciness of Talking Stick or Camelback Ranch.
On the side of that paddle, there's dip switches on the antenna.
Spring training for everyone, folks.
Dip switches.
Trying out some new things. But there are some other cool things here that are worth noting.
Switch. I need you to push it all the way to the front.
Make sure that guy's pushing his dip switch. This is the kind of stuff that happens at the ballpark before it opens. So what I'm talking about is this scoreboard. The Maryvale scoreboard used to be like something you would have seen maybe in your junior high gym. And now it is a full color scoreboard. We notice it does not have instant replay, but it makes a huge difference. They've also kind of cantilevered out these
shade bars.
So yeah, so it gets really, really sunny and hot here. And there's a little bit more shade now to go along with that. They changed the entrances also.
It also protects people from foul balls, I'm sure.
I think the foul balls could probably fall right through there.
Well, they do, but they'll bounce around a little bit.
Okay. They also changed the entrances here. Following me?
Yeah.
Okay. So it used to be that you entered kind of behind the first base dugout. Now they have two entrances. As you can see, one is by the team store, which is a big, huge team store. And you can get into it separate of getting into the game. And the other entrance is down the right field line, which is where the kids line up to sign autographs with the players. So this is significant for a few reasons. Obviously, merchandise and spring training is like half the reason you go. And it used to be where they had this tiny little store that you couldn't get into unless you already bought tickets, and it was really expensive, like $50 t-shirts. But
lines around the corner,
and you know. And now the Brewers have taken over their own merchandise, and they dropped the prices. So we bought some pretty cool t-shirts for I think $24 to $28 yesterday, which, while that is expensive for a t-shirt, it's not expensive for a Brewers spring training.
For some reason, my Muscles shirt without sleeves cost like $6 more.
That's very confusing, because you'd think with less material it would cost less money. So there is increased the bottleneck that used to exist in the concourse, where they made it a little skinny and people get kind of stuck up, has been expanded. So it's just a generally more relaxed experience here. Some of the stuff that we love, having been coming here, Aaron and I have been coming here since 1998, is we love the berm. Little spring training tip: when you're buying tickets, buy the grass seats, because this is not, I think, you've been to the Grapefruit League in Florida.
Just once, okay. Yes.
And a lot of those have seats in the outfield, I believe.
Yeah, it's a lot more concrete out there, a lot less grass.
But this is like primo, like lying down, tanning material.
Like instead of bleachers, you get to just put your feet in fresh grass.
And this year at Maryvale, they expanded some of the concessions out into the outfield also. So, I guess what I'm getting at is the intimacy of the experience at Maryvale and at all of the Cactus League is really different than what it's like in Milwaukee. You're here with all the minor league players, all the major league players, so there are like 200 Brewers running around at all times, and you can just kind of go up to them. There are definitely people who are autograph seekers and kids who are trying to shake hands and stuff, but if you're not into that and you just want to watch a whole bunch of baseball being played by the Brewers of the future, and the Brewers of today. Another thing we learned is, well, the dimensions of this field match Miller Park, mm-hmm. right? So that was one of the things that...
And the practice field as well.
Right, but Maryvale predated Miller Park by 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
So that was one of the selling points when they built this place, is it was a place for current Brewers to experience what the outfield lines were going to be like at Miller Park. They've expanded that to one of their new practice fields. So that makes a big difference for these outfielders who need to learn the lines mm-hmm. of the ballpark in Milwaukee.
It's muscle memory.
You can't really see it from here.
Morning.
Morning. But if you were to get up in the press box, which is now brown, it used to be blue, you will be able to get a view of the Camelback Mountains in the background, which is a pretty stunning view. But unfortunately from here, we're too low to see it. What else can I tell you about Maryvale, or American Family Fields of Phoenix?
Well, this little area over here is where many young boys and girls like to roll around, roll balls up and down the hills, play catch with each other throughout the game. It's quite a hallmark of childhood for them.
So I guess what we're trying to say is this place is still basic compared to some of the, like the Dodgers ballpark in Camelback Ranch is really, really nice. The Diamondbacks play at Talking Stick, which is really, really, really nice. Maryvale remains kind of basic. It's centrally located, because this ballparks are pretty spread out around the valley. But, you know, the big knock is everyone says, well, Maryvale is a scary neighborhood. It's not. It's not the kind of place you would necessarily plan your social time around for that. Just stay in Scottsdale. But it is probably the most centrally located ballpark in all the Cactus League. It's like a 15-minute drive from anywhere. And, you know, it's about time the Brewers get a place that represents how good they're going to be on the field this year. And there's a lot of excitement. People have told me you can't tell how good a team is going to be based on how they play during spring training, because it's not about winning games. But I'll tell you what, when I saw them in 2008, 2011, I saw crispness of the play that I didn't see in 2002 and 2004 and all those other years. And they look good. So over here is another one of the practice fields. They're just fields everywhere. It's like, this is a 60-acre facility, which is quite big. So all the major leaguers and minor leaguers are all kind of playing around here at the same time. The guys who don't have numbers on their jerseys or names on the back of their jerseys are the people who aren't on the 40-man roster, to the best of my knowledge. So anyway, that's our Instagram story. We're gonna sit around and watch some baseball. I think maybe we're gonna sit on the berm, taking the sun a little bit. Because as much as I like that air-conditioned press box, it's a little quiet for my liking. And we'll get back to you. Thanks.